Hi, this is Jaya. Now we shall see the summary of The Dear Departed, written by Stanley Horton. This is actually a very humorous one-act play, and it really satirizes the degradation of the values which is now at present practiced by the English society. In this, we find the main character as Abel Meriwether. He is a 72-year-old man and he has two daughters, Amelia Slater and Elizabeth Jordan. Now, what happens is this Stanley Horton, he is staying with Amelia in her house, and Amelia has a daughter named Victoria, and Elizabeth Jordan has a son named Jimmy. Now, in the morning, Amelia goes in search of her father to give him something. But when she enters into his room, she finds that his body is cold and he is not responding. And since he is 72 years old and the situation is like this, she decides he is dead and she sends this information to her sister. And she immediately dresses herself in the morning dress. And she starts preparing herself in such a way that she is shown that she is mourning. And she asks her husband Henry also to wear Abel's slippers because now he is dead. So she says, you take his slippers and you wear it. And then she sees the clock and she keeps it with her. And then she sees the bureau there. And she thinks that she has to take the bureau before Elizabeth could come and ask for it. So with lots of difficulty, she brings down the bureau. That is, in short, she starts taking all the belongings of her father because she wants everything for herself. Now what happens is, she goes to the extreme of asking her daughter is Victoria, to see if anyone is coming. And Victoria, who's standing near the door, she says that I can see Elizabeth coming. And immediately Amelia says, you lock the door and pretend as though something is delaying you and don't allow her inside till she arranges everything in the place. That is, she wants to bring the bureau down. She wants to take all the belongings of her father into her own place so that no one else could claim for it. In short, she is greedy and she wants everything for herself. And then afterwards, she straightens her hair and she asks Henry to keep a magazine in front of him. And she also makes him to put on his coat, so showing that he is mourning. Elizabeth comes inside and she inquires about Abel's death and she says, why you didn't take him to the doctor immediately? That is what you should have done. And this actually irritates Amelia, but she knows that what Elizabeth is asking is correct. And then afterwards she prepares tea and she gives to Elizabeth. And they start planning to publish an obituary column in the newspaper. And they come out with different ideas. And suddenly Elizabeth notices the bureau near the stairs. And she asks about it, and Amelia very coolly says that Henry, her husband, brought it. And Henry stands speechless. He does, because he knows that it is not the truth. But Amelia claims that it is their bureau. And then afterwards, they start checking about his premium, that is his insurance premium, whether he has paid that month so that they can go and claim for the money immediately. That is, if you have paid your insurance premium to date, you can claim for it immediately. And they are worried about it. So Amelia sends Victoria to her father's room, that is to Abel Meriwether's room, to see where the insurance papers are, so that they can find out whether he has paid the latest premium. And Victoria goes to her grandfather's room and she comes back scared. Her face is different. And they ask her, why, what happened? And she says, Grandpa is getting up. And everyone is shocked. And when they look up, they find Abel Meriwether coming down the stairs. Actually, he is not dead. And Amelia has decided in her haste that he is dead. And both the daughters, they cannot believe their eyes. And Abel comes there, and Emilia even goes to the extent of poking him and seeing whether he is really dead or are they imagining things. And Henry moves a few steps behind, and he looks really ghastly because he's scared. And Abel is not able to understand the situation. He asks why everyone is in the mourning dress and what happened. Is anyone else in the family dead? And meanwhile, the two daughters starts shouting at each other, quarreling. And from their argument, Abel comes to understand that they have thought that he is dead. And looking around, Abel understands that his daughters were also looking for his belongings, and he understood that they were not actually mourning for his death, but they were only worried about what they will get from his belongings, how they can divide their share. And then he says, I have taken three decisions. One thing is, now I understand I have to pay my premium insurance this month. I have not done it. First, I will update it. Second thing is, he says, I am going to change my will. And he says that I am going to marry Mrs. John Sherrox of Ringo Bells, because he is very sure that she will not consider him a burden and take care of him with love and affection. And he says, I am going to change my will, and I am going to put all my whatever is belonging to me, I am going to give it to Mrs. John Sherrox. And then he thanks Amelia for shifting the bureau downstairs so that it will be easy for him to take the bureau to Ringo Bells. And now Elizabeth also comes to know that the bureau actually belongs to her father and not to Amelia. And the selfish daughters, they are really shocked, because they have lost not their father but their father's belongings. And the one-act play ends here. It's a very beautiful satire on the society. I hope you've liked the video. Share it with your friends. And if you're not subscribed to my channel, please subscribe. Thank you.